In this lesson, we will look at subtraction of fractions by finding the difference in the shaded amounts of two baths. Then we will look at a game, similar to a tug-of-war or rope-pulling, in which a player's gain is determined by the difference in the shaded amounts of two baths. Let's find the difference in shaded amounts for the 5/6 bath and the 1/3 bath. Now we can lay straws across here and see that the difference is 3 parts out of 6. Let's just write that down. 5/6 minus 1/3 equals 3/6. Or we can add up from the smaller amount to the larger. We could take this 3/6 bar and see if we put that here, addition, putting end to end, we end up with 5 parts out of 6. So these two shaded amounts are equal now. So this shows a close relationship between subtraction and addition. We can compare two shaded amounts to get the difference, or we can add up from the smaller amount to the larger amount. Let's find the difference for the 2/3 bar and the 1/2 bar. Now again, we're going to use straws to see this difference. Now the students would be drawing lines across the bars on the worksheets, and we'll find a bar that fills that amount in. So 1 part out of 6 is going to do that. Or again, we could think about adding up from 1/2. 1/2 plus 1/6 is going to be 2/3. So let's write that equation down. 2/3 minus 1/2 equals 1/6. Now for the twelfths family of fractions, the halves, thirds, fourths, sixths, and twelfths, the difference between any two bars can always be found by a third bar. Now we found the 1 part out of 6, 1/6 bar. We also might have used the 2 parts out of 12. So we could write down here 1/6 or 2/12. For an activity, students can turn all the twelfths family fraction bars face down, select any two, and write a subtraction equation for the difference between the larger and smaller fractions. Some differences will be zero. Or this activity can be done with the halves, fifths, and tenths. That is for the tenths family. The capture mat shown here is designed for the twelfths family to compare the shaded amounts of two bars. One marker is placed at the center step, and both players take a bar at the same time. So let's suppose that player B takes a bar of 3 parts out of 4 shaded, and player A takes this bar right here for 4/6. And player A now is going to get 2, 4, 6, 8 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And player B is going to get 9 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now we're counting the center step as you go through. We see that player B has gained 1 step. Now one thing that the players will eventually notice is that if they both have the same amount, there's no need of moving the marker. The two cancel each other out. And then later they'll see that whoever gets the greater shaded amount is the only player that needs to move, and the amount they move is the difference between the two shaded amounts. Now eventually the marker is going to get down here close to one of these goals. Let's suppose it's right here. And player A gets 5/6 bar, and player B gets the 1/3 bar. So now player A is going to get 10 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Player B is going to get 4 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4. So player A has captured the marker because it's in that goal, and both players have taken their shaded amounts for that turn. Now, if player B, instead of getting 1/3, they got, say, 11/12, and we started right here. So player A is going to get 10 steps to come in. Player B is going to get 11. So player B is actually going to gain a step. And even though the mark was in the goal, it's out of the goal by the end of the turn, so the game continues. On the back of this mat, there's a similar game for the tenths family, for the family of halves, fifths, and tenths. One marker placed at the center position, and again, both players take a bar at the same time. The reason for this is that if they both take a bar at the same time, they will eventually compare the bars and see that it's the difference between the shaded amounts that determines who moves and how far they move. The fraction number lines we constructed in step 3 of basic concepts can be used for finding the difference of the fractions for the bars. For example, if we have the 3/4 bar, let's place it up here. We can see that the shaded amount goes up here to 9/12. And then the second bar, let's say 1/3, and we can see that shaded amount goes up here to the 0.4/12. So the difference between these two shaded amounts is going to be this interval here, and we can see that that's 5/12. And so we have the equation 3/4 minus 1/3 equal 5/12. These lines can also be used for a number lines race. Each player would place a marker above the 0.2 and then select a bar. Tells how far the marker can be moved. So in this case, it's going to be going down to this point here. So the player has moved from 2 down to the 0.1 4/12, so 1 1/3. And players continue to select bars and move the marker to the left, and the object being to get the marker above the 0.0. Now for this first step here, if the equation was written, it would be 2 minus 4/6 equal 1 4/12, or 1 1/3. This is a number lines side 1 mat from the fraction bars materials. It has lines for halves, thirds, fourths, sixths, and twelfths. Each student has a mat, and they place markers above the 5 endpoints on the mat. And then they take turns selecting bars, with the object being to move 2 of their 5 markers to be exactly above the 0 points. For example, if a student selects a 3/4 bar, they cannot move on the halves line because there is no point above the end of the shaded amount. Also, they cannot move on the thirds line. But they can move on the fourths line to the 0.2 1/4. They cannot move on the sixth line, but they can move on the 12th line to the 0.2 3/12. In fact, the marker can always be moved on the 12th line for the shaded amount of any bar, but the problem is the player needs to get the exact amount to get to the 0 point. Now the back of this mat has number lines for fourths, fifths, sixths, eighths, tenths, and twelfths. And a similar game can be played by moving markers from the points above 3 to the points above 0. The following is a brief introduction to the number lines racing game on fractionbars.com. In this game, the player will move 2 markers along 2 number lines. The object is to move either marker to a point above 0. The fraction on the card, or its equivalent, should be subtracted from the number below the marker. If the player can move a marker to a point above 0 without missing more than 2 moves, the player wins the game.